We are under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of Baseball on MLB Network. Tonight, the first of this quick two-game series between the San Diego Padres and the Arizona Diamondbacks. It's Baseball on MLB Network, and it's coming up next. Madison Bumgarner, a lefty from North Carolina, gets the starting assignment. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, Matty V, a little bit of a mixed bag with this guy. An ERA of over 4 in his last 3 starts. He's either been really good or really bad, and recently he's been more bad than good. It'll be interesting to see if he can turn it around and pitch better in this one here today.
So here's Will Myers. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right, and that'll move the count to 1-2 now. The pitch. And a good pitch there as this is swung on and missed for the first out of the ball game. Here's Juan Lagares. Lifetime numbers against Bumgarner. The pitcher's owned him. He's a paltry 1-for-11. Here's the 1-1. Starting to get a bit chilly here tonight. 57 degrees at game time. The 1-2. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Marte is under it. 2 gone. Next to the plate for the Padres, Tommy Pham. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Swung on, and this ball is absolutely crushed. Forget about it. And that one is gone on a 2-strike count with 2 away in the inning. A solo shot that time for Tommy Pham. 6th home run on the season for him, and the Padres bust out in front 1-0.
What a way to get things started while playing on the road. Top of the first and a big fly. Just like that, they take the lead.
At the plate, Fernando Tatis Jr. All even now, 2-2. Bases are empty here with 2 men out. And another foul ball. On the screws to shortstop, but caught to retire the side. Zach Davies gets the call for game 1 of the series. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, thanks, Matt. Zach Davies coming on the pitch. Not a big, strong guy, but he's a control guy that pumps the strike zone full of strikes. 89 to 92 miles an hour with sink. Has a curveball, has the slider, and also the straight changeup. He needs all 4 of his pitches, not overpowering. You'll know if he's on early, he'll be throwing a lot of ground balls.
runs up and gets this one down, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Now a changeup locks him up as he looks at strike three called, one away.
Flat out locked him up with a changeup right there. Usually you're trying for a swing and miss when you throw that pitch in a two strike count, but clearly he wasn't looking for it, so it's a backwards K for him.
Into the box, Nick Ahmed. And a bouncing ball, foul. The 2-2. Hit out towards second. In time to first, and there are two away. Set to get his evening at the plate started, Ketel Marte, and it's been a real struggle for him with the bat so far this year, looking to get things turned around in a hurry. The 1-1 home. And there are our umpires calling balls and strikes is Mr. Ed Drummond.
Yeah, Matty, we got a good one behind the dish today in Ed Drummond. Well liked by all people, pitchers, batters, managers. All you want as a player is the ability to talk to someone. And that's what Ed does. He gives you that chance.
Zero.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. Diamondbacks down in order. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Here's Manny Machado now, and he's a guy really in need of something to click at the plate right now. It's been a rough go for him. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Now here's the pitch. Hit hard on the ground to third. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. So the bases are empty with one man gone, and that'll bring up the power hitting second baseman Brian Dozier. Now the payoff pitch home. Drilled on the ground to short. Ahmed fields it cleanly. On to first, and Bumgarner's rolled him right through him here. Two away now. Coming to the plate now, Josh Naylor. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. Slap hard the opposite way. And he dives to make a spectacular catch. What a play there to end the inning. Worth a second look here as this is a beauty to end the inning. More from MLB Network Saturday Baseball after this. Up next for Arizona, David Peralta. And check out the recent numbers, clearly providing a lot of thump at the plate right now. The 1-1. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Myers going back to the track. Gone! A solo shot that time for the former pitcher David Peralta. Sixth home run on the season for him, and the Diamondbacks strike here to make it a 1-1 ball game.
If you're going to give up a towering blast to one of the best players in their lineup, it's better to do it with no one on base. It stings, sure, but a solo shot isn't going to be the deciding factor in the game.
At the plate now, Eduardo Escobar. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. No outs, nobody on. Drilled right back up the middle. Fielded cleanly. on to first, so a good bounce back pitch there as he gets the ground ball for the first out. Ready now for the Diamondbacks, Christian Walker, and he's definitely off to a fast start in the early part of the season. 1-1. Bases are empty, one man out. Left center, base hit. Around first, digging for two. And he'll reach second now with one away.
As a hitter, the only feeling better than hitting a bomb is driving one into the gap like that. He hustled out of the box knowing he was guaranteed a double, but I think he had thoughts of maybe a triple if the outfielder hadn't gotten it back in right away.
Yeah, there really wasn't any question about that one going for extra bases off the bat. Into the box now, Stephen Vogt. He's ready for his first at-bat of this early season contest. Guys, the Swingin' Friars, as they take the field here tonight, they come in not exactly setting the world on fire as they've dropped five of their last eight ball games.
Yeah, Matty, these are one of those road trips where you feel like you're actually playing at home. No offense to the home crowd, but they're going to travel well. Not difficult for the fans to get in their car, hit a highway, pick up two tickets, grab a hot dog, and watch somebody go deep.
A two-ball, two-strike count to the Diamondbacks catcher. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Hit back up the middle. He's got it. And there's out number two. Stepping up now, Ildemaro Vargas. He's ready for his first at-bat of this early season contest. The 1-1. 2-1. In the air into shallow left center. Here comes a left fielder. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Some of our nation's young minds and future leaders here in attendance. Yikes. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. Into the box now, Francisco Mejia. He's ready for his first at-bat of this early season contest. The 1-1 misses for the second ball. And that misses off the plate and low, so it's 3-1 now.
You can bet they love ball four here. That gives the pitcher on deck an obvious bunt situation to move the runner into scoring position.
Swing, strike two.
He was in a great hitter's count, should have been looking dead red, but instead chases after a pitch that he couldn't do anything with and would have walked him.
And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
And I'm pretty sure he thought that was a strike. He's thinking, what do I have to do? Put a bow on it? Walk it down and put it in the catcher's glove by myself? I think it got called a little outside, so he has to put it behind him now.
Digging in, Zach Davies, a textbook sack bunt situation here. And the pitcher is in fact bunting here as he puts this one down to second for one, on to first to complete the double play.
Oh, that's the last thing you want to happen when you're trying to bunt a guy into scoring position. He got it down, but you have to deaden the ball too. Otherwise, these infielders just eat it up and turn it into a double play.
Here's Will Myers. Two out, nobody on. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Padres go down quietly. After two and a half, it remains a 1-1 ball game. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Stepping in, Madison Bumgarner, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. A chance here for Dozier at second. Right to him. And that's out number one. So with one away now, let's quickly give you a look at the standings in the National League West entering play today as you see where these two teams sit in relation to one another. So it's back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring up Starling Marte. One out, nobody on. There's a drive out toward the alley in right center. On his way to second goes Marte. And this will get to the wall out near the pool area. And he's in there easily at second with a one-out double.
Man, that's a nice job by the batter right there, keeping the front side in. Not easy on a curveball. Would have been easy to throw to front side and hook that foul, but he was able to stay inside and drive it for a base hit.
Into the box now, Nick Ahmed. Strike called. Now the throw down is not close as he's in there with a stolen base.
One of the keys to stealing third is to get a big lead off a second, and that's just what happened, even though this catcher has a cannon for an arm.
Just hung in there on that one. Marte stands at third with one gone in the inning. Protecting with two strikes, went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. The 1-2. Hit out toward second. Dozier has it. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score. Plate, Ketel Marte. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout. The 1-1. 2-1. Could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2. I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Wow, was he behind that fastball? Great job on the mound using the curveball to set up the heater.
And they could go either way now, I suppose. And Tatis is there to end the inning. So it's one run, one hit, no errors, and no one left on base. Three innings complete. It's the D-backs 2 and the Padres 1. Here's Juan Ligares now. He's got a base hit tonight as we begin the top of the fourth. Started to go around, but he's able to check his swing for ball three.
Name of the game out on the mound is to disrupt timing of the hitters in the box. He's certainly got this guy on the defensive.
into his motion. Here comes the 3-1. Into center field, line drive, base hit.
There's a lot of moving parts in some guys' swings. It usually takes them a month or so to get it ironed out.
Stepping in now, Tommy Pham. And it's 1-2.
Yeah, 1-2.
And he lays off the fastball away, so it's 2-2 now. Swing and a liner. In there, a base hit. And that's the first down.
Oh, man, I don't know how that happened. Looked to be a base hit to the outfield, but then all of a sudden the throw comes in and they get the force on the play. To be honest, that just can't happen.
And that'll bring up Fernando Tatis Jr. He's 0-for-1 thus far. The 3-1. Takes this the other way to right. Marte is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. So a runner at first with two away, and standing in now, the always dangerous third baseman, Manny Machado. The 3-1. Oh, right back to him on the mound. And he'll flip it onto first, and with it, that ends the inning. One left for San Diego. They still trail it here, 2-1. Bottom of the inning now, trying to pick things up where we left off. David Peralta, he got a hold of one and went yard in his first appearance in this one. Now the 1-1 pitch is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
1-2.
One, two is an off speed pitch. No dice. It's 2-2. Tried to bury one down and away, but it's full count now. 3-2. Eduardo Escobar will be next. Slice down the left side, but foul. The next 3-2. Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one. Digging in for his second at-bat, Eduardo Escobar. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time. Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second. And the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he's safe at first.
Man, there's just no excuse for a middle infielder to make a play like that, especially your shortstop. Looked like a routine play, but for some reason, he just pulled the first baseman off the bag. It happens, but you never want to give a team extra outs.
So it's a runner at first as a result of the throwing error. And next to bat will be the first baseman, Christian Walker. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Two runs, three hits. No errors so far for the Diamondbacks. Base hit, line drive into the corner. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one-out double. But baseball is a game of streaks and runs, and he is on one right now.
No question, he's swinging the bat very well of late. And when that's the case, you can't wait to get in the batter's box. Definitely the case in this game. That's his second base knock, this one for extra bases.
That's now two hits so far for him in this one. Standing in now, Stephen Vogt. Fouled straight back. Fourth inning of a 2-1 ball game. Good job going down and hanging with it that time. The next 1-2 pitch.
Ball, second time.
Good take right there. He's given him a great battle with guys in scoring position. We'll see who's going to win this duel.
The 2-2.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as the offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
Another full count pitch on its way. That's popped up, but this will land untouched. Making him work out there, the ninth pitch of the at bat coming up. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
Oh, I love watching a pitcher that can run a good hard fastball in on a guy's hands and completely lock him up. That's such a tough pitch to do anything with. If you can locate your fastball there consistently, you're going to have a lot of success as a pitcher.
So now to the plate, Ildemaro Vargas. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. Popped up. Machado shading to his right. He's got it, and that'll get him out of the jam. Diamondbacks strand a pair. They lead it 2-1. And back in Phoenix as we check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, I talked with San Diego's manager during the inning break about the Padres' offensive production to this point. And he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs. So the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
All right, thanks, Heidi. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. The 3-2 one more time. And he grooves the fastball there. This is hit high and deep out to straightaway center field. Into the pool area and gone. It's a solo shot here from Brian Dozier. Second home run early in the year. And the Padres have come back to tie this one at 2 apiece.
You don't see this very often off of this starting pitcher. This guy's not used to giving up some bombs, so I'm sure that'll be a wake-up call, and he'll start throwing some better pitches.
Into the box, Josh Naylor. And it's fouled away. The next 3-2. There's ball four.
Ball four.
Standing in, Francisco Mejia. He drew a walk his first time up. Two runs, three hits, and one error for the Padres so far. in the dirt here. Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. From the belt, kicks and deals. Boy, he just threw that fastball by him.
Good thing he didn't make contact with that pitch. Only thing he could do is probably hit that on the ground. It could be a double play ball.
Even at 2 balls and 2 strikes, here's the pitch.
4 count, 3-2.
And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out. And now time will be called here as you see the pitching coach making his way out to the mound to pay a quick visit. So here now is the pitcher, Zach Davies, comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. One home is going to be a sacrifice attempt as he gets it down. There's one relay throw, but it'll be too late as he's well safe at first. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in Will Myers, and their runners at the corners now. Runners are at first and third, one away. On the ground is short. This could be two. There is a man. The second for one. Back to first, and he throws it away. Not particularly graceful there, and as a result, he'll be slapped with an E4 on the play. Digging in to try it again, Juan Ligares, runner in scoring position with two gone. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Right. 2-2 is a changeup that misses, 3-2.
For the guy in the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
He's set the payoff pitch. Boy, not close again. His third walk of the inning as that misses for ball four.
Well, it's obvious that earlier home run he gave up is still on his mind. He had him 3-2, but he didn't want to give him anything over the heart of the plate to hit, so we'll see if that walk comes back to hurt him.
So two on with two away, and up next it'll be the outfielder Tommy Pham. Line to the right side, but a foul ball. With runners in scoring position this season, Pham averages a hit once every 4 at-bats, an average at exactly 250. 1-2, here it is. Hit on the ground out to short. On to second for the force out, and the side is retired. So 2 runs on 1 hit, and the one hit was a big one, the home run. Last half of the fifth coming up. The Padres lead it 3-2. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the commercial break, I had a chance to catch up with manager Torrey Lovello about the Diamondbacks' offensive production. And one thing he stressed to me was the need for them to have better at-bats when they've got runners on base. They've had their opportunities with runners in scoring position, but still have 0 hits to show for it in those situations. He said repeatedly not coming through with a big hit can wear on you as a team, but in this sport, you have to dwell on the positives. He's confident they'll find a way to break through sooner or later.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. And he misses with it, ball four. And a terrible start to the inning as he's walked the pitcher leading things off.
And this is exactly what you want to do when you're trying to put a start away. Make him work his tail off, throw a lot of pitches and get on base any way that you can. A big inning at this point of the game, and he's probably gone.
Here's Starling Marte. He hit a two-bagger and later scored in his previous plate appearance.
Yeah, give me a repeat performance of that last double. With a man on first right now, let him run, get you a living.
Sometimes you got to be aggressive offensively, but sometimes you just let the pitcher dig his own grave. Patience and discipline seem to be the way to go right here.
Line drive to center field. Lagares is there, and he has it for the first out. So a runner at first with one man gone, and that means that Nick Ahmed will be the next to bat. And that misses ball four. So it's first and second now with only one away.
And this is the kind of thing that's been happening to him all season long. He'll cruise for a while, hitting his spots, and all of a sudden the wheels come off and he struggles. We'll see if he can recover here.
A 1-1. That's lifted the other way out to left. Pham comes on now and puts it away for the second out of the inning. So stepping in, David Peralta, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. A couple of walks, but no damage. More of MLB Network's Saturday Baseball after this. Up next is Fernando Tatis Jr. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here.
Yeah, he hit it hard. That's all you can ask. You can't control the result sometimes, Matty. Just unlucky with the placement.
To the left side, but it's well foul. Now the 3-2 pitch. Line drive to left. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. So the leadoff man's aboard in their half of the sixth inning.
Sometimes you get lucky in this game. I don't think pitch recognition wise he would choose to swing at that exact pitch. But you know what? Sometimes result is the only thing that matters.
Now here comes the Arizona skipper up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And he's going to make a move here. So that'll do it tonight for Madison Bumgarner. He'll wind up lasting just five innings here. Didn't pitch all that poorly, yet he's gone nonetheless. Mike Leake takes the ball here as he'll enter with a runner at first and nobody out. Here's a look over to first, and the runner back safely. Hits are now even at four apiece. In now, Manny Machado. Hit the other way out toward right field. Marte on the move. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. Brian Dozier will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here. A solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. The 1-1 takes a pitch for strike number two.
can't come out of his game plan right here. He knows he's a known sinker baller. I know it was a four-seamer right there, but get back to that two-seam. It's what his MO is.
The 1-2.
Well, two straight fastballs inside haven't put him away, so now it'll be interesting to see what he turns to.
The 2-2. Hit hard to third, and that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit.
Hey, you know what? Right there, he executed a pitch. He can't worry about where it's going. He just wants to put it on the ground right there, give his defense a chance to work, and it found a hole, period, the end.
To the plate now, Josh Naylor. And this will be fouled away. Here's another 1-2. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Oh, and a fine play there as he ranges back to put this one away. Not an easy play by any means, and there are two gone. Ready for another chance? Francisco Mejia. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. Ready with the 1-1. Ground ball left side. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Padres leave a pair, and it remains a 3-2 ball game. Drew Pomeranz enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth. Eduardo Escobar standing in. He's 0-for-2 thus far in this one. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Two balls, one strike.
Great situation right here. Leading off the inning, you've got to find a way to get on base any way possible. But I don't like to take the aggression away from hitters. If it's in your zone, I want you swinging.
It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. Line down the left field line. But this is foul near the seats. The next 3-2. And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth.
And that's what you want from your leadoff hitter. Show some great patience and discipline, making the pitcher labor to start the game. The result is a leadoff walk and a chance to make some early noise.
Digging in and looking for more, Christian Walker. It was a two-bagger for him in his last at-bat.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time. Would love to have a meeting at the mound right now with the pitcher. Don't understand that pitch down and in with a fastball with two strikes. Maybe he's looking for a ground ball.
Padres are going to get something going out in the bullpen now as a left-hander has stood up to throw. And he comes back with one down and in for ball three. And he goes with the pitch here and drives it the other way to deep right. Myers going back, still ranging back. And they take the lead. It's gone. A two-run blast to straightaway right field. Home run number 5 on the year as they take the lead 4-3.
There's still some game left to be played, but that one swing could end up being a deciding factor in this one.
At the plate, Stephen Vogt. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1.
Well, we all know he's not the greatest threat with the bat up there. His numbers certainly aren't that pretty. But, hey, I give him credit. He's really working the count right here.
Grounded up the first baseline. A dive, but it's off his glove. And he'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the out. In now, Guillermo Vargas. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far. Hits are even right now at 5 aside. Oh, shaking his head on that knuckle curve. 1-2. A chance here for Dozier at second. And there are two away now. Domingo Leyva will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. Nope. And able to lay off the fastball away here. 2-1 now. And he fouls this one off. Pomerantz is ready. The 2-2 pitch. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now. 3-2.
That pitch was way down on 2-2, but give the hitter some.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. But the Diamondbacks pick up a couple courtesy of this two-run home run. The 9-1-2 hitters do up to start the seventh. It's now 4-3 Arizona. Stefan Crichton is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7. Eric Hosmer will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run. With a swing and a deep drive to right. That one is out of here. This game is tied. A solo home run here off the bat of Eric Hosmer. Home run number 3 here in the early going, as that'll pull him even at 4 apiece. Well, one of the narratives of today's game has been driven by the long ball. We've seen these squads go deep a combined 5 times in this one.
Matty V, this is turning into Home Run Derby Part 2. D-Row, 5 bombs already in this one.
Yeah, there's a fight at the bat rack for both teams right here. A lot of mislocations right out over the heart of the plate, and neither side is missing.
A 1-2 count to Will Myers.
It's not easy to get your barrel to a pitch that high. That could be an effective location as long as he keeps it above the letters.
Hit hard towards center. Solid base hit for him, his first of the afternoon.
Even though that pitcher was able to execute in off the plate, batter was able to keep his hands inside that baseball and drive it up the middle.
Before the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. Go-ahead runs aboard here at first with nobody out. At the plate now, Juan Ligares. down the first baseline. Lofted in the air out toward right center. After it is Marte. And he tracks it down. Nice play for the first down. Now batting, Tommy Pham. One in, one out, and one on here in the inning. The 1-1 pitch. And he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. Before the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
One of the toughest pitches to hit, the straight changeup, right? El Cambio. Hadn't seen it in that entire at-bat, and what happens? Gets the string pulled on him right there. Had no chance to put that ball in play.
Stepping in now, Fernando Tatis Jr. Frozen on strike three for the final out of the inning. Padres strike back to tie things on the solo home run. Bottom of the seventh inning coming up. Get up and stretch. All even now at four apiece. Craig Stammen gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. Digging in next will be Starling Marte. Hit the ball pretty well in his last at-bat, but it resulted in a line-out.
Yeah, Matty, but as he walks to the plate right here, he feels good building off that last AB. He hit that ball on the screws.
And a 3-2 full count to Starling Marte. Stammen has pitched north of 700 innings in the majors and hangs an ERA just a little over 3.5. There's a swing and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. And he's going to make the catch on the warning track. A fine running play there for the first out. Digging in once again, Nick Ahmed. It was a walk in his last trip. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. And he lays off the pitch down and away. Ball two. The 2-1 home to third. Throw gets him, two down. Digging in now, Ketel Marte. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. He couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane of the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. The 1-2. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And that nearly broke our tie, but instead it's a foul ball. The 1-2 hit down the line at first, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. The pitch.
I got to count 2-2.
This is exactly the reason why this guy has been so successful and has played this game so long, scrambling pitch after pitch, making this guy work out on the mound.
Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. Skied in the air to straightaway left. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. Still all square at four apiece. Merrill Kelly will come on in relief now as he'll make his 10th appearance of the season. Now at the plate, Manny Machado. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Swing and a miss, and that'll fill the count at 3-2.
Hey, boys, you talking about getting your ace swing off right here? That's what it looks like. A guy with massive power letting it eat.
And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up where he can really hurt you.
Here's Brian Dozier now. Working for the punch out and the offering. This is line to left. Peralta is there and he makes the catch for the out. Stepping up to the plate, Josh Naylor. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. The 1-2. Action now in the Arizona bullpen as they have a right-hander up and throwing. On the ground to first. Can this be two? One there. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left. Home half of the eighth straight ahead. And we are tied 4-4. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Jose Castillo is in out of the bullpen now as he'll be inserted into the number six spot following the double switch. Greg Garcia will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number nine hold in the order here on that double switch. Bottom of inning number eight set to go. So here's the cleanup hitter, David Peralta. Perhaps he can drive another one out of the park just like he did back in the second. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Starts to go around, but the home plate umpire says he held up ball two. Inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
This is pulled into right. Myers is there to put it away for out number one.
I know they say sometimes that these things even out, but that was a bullet line drive that gets caught. He would have represented the go-ahead run.
So here's Eduardo Escobar. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. The 1-2. Slow roller down the third baseline. On to first, and there were two down. Striding in, Christian Walker. He went deep for a two-run homer in his previous at-bat.
The last at-bat, Matty D, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. Now the 1-2.
Hey, there's not a lot you can do with a slider breaking down and in unless you catch it way out front. I like the idea of taking it and making the pitcher bring you something a little more hittable.
Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. Diamondbacks down in order. This game's all tied at 4. New inning set to get underway. Ready for another shot now. Francisco Mejia will swing it from the left side right here.
One of the things this guy would like to do from the left side is swing it a little bit better against right-handed pitching. This guy has decent numbers, but not great numbers against right-handed pitchers.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Center fielder giving chase, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first down. So digging in now, Greg Garcia. He's ready for his first at-bat of this early season contest. The 2-1 home. Is strike two swinging. Bases are empty, one man out. Softly hit out to short. And that's the second out. So striding in, Will Myers. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. Bases are empty here with two men out. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two.
Hey, curveball that kind of backed up on him right there. Might have popped out of his hand just a little bit earlier than he intended.
And the 2-1. Nope. Weak grounder down the first baseline, but a foul ball, and it's full now at 3-2. Skied into straightaway right. Marte is under it. And that's the third out. Three up, three down for San Diego. Score remains tied at 4. All set for the bottom of the ninth. Now at the plate, Stephen Vogt, who could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. The 1-1 home. Misses, ball two.
Great job to be able to lay off that pitch right there. You could tell the minute it came out of his hand, his eyes lit up at the plate.
Tried to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. The 2-2. Full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Guillermo Vargas is on deck. 3-2 pitch. And a good pitch there as this ball swung on and popped straight up the chute right around home plate. And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one. Digging in, Guillermo Vargas. He's hitless in 3 at-bats to this point. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And he'll put this away for the second out. Carson Kelly will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. Two out, nobody on. Fouled off. Here's the 1-2. Now a swing and a fly ball. And it's a foul ball. Now another pitch is hit foul and headed for the seats, so the count will stay put at 1-2. A ball and two strikes. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. Still all square at 4 apiece. Kevin Ginkle takes the mound as he'll be the first man to pitch here in extra innings. Now in the box, Juan Ligares. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. The 1-1 home. Waves and misses for strike number two. Ginkle, a California-born ball player. He was taken in the 22nd round back in the 2016 first-year player draft.
Hey, this guy's got a chance to be an absolute steal. Being drafted where he was, there are definite signs that he has a chance to make an impact at the big league level.
And that's high for a ball. It's 2-2. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. Vargas backs up a bit and he takes charge for the first out. Striding into the box, Tommy Pham. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. But that'll hit off the wall in left center. And he is in the second base with one away as the go-ahead run.
Wow, he was willing that thing to get out of here. Would have given them the lead right here late in the game, but it ends up hitting off the wall, and he heads into second with an extra base hit. We'll see if the next man up can come through in the clutch here.
Into the box, Fernando Tatis Jr. hit in the air out toward left. Peralta is right there as he'll put it away without much problem for the second out. And in steps Manny Machado. And now indication from the dugout that they'll issue the free pass, and with the pitcher on deck, that'll force their hand here with two gone.
That's what's called getting the treatment. Everyone knows he's a power threat with a bat, so it's all about not letting him be the guy that beats you.
Trent Grisham will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line. Grounded up the first baseline, but this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. Fastball well outside. Two men are on with two men out. Fouled away. Two and two. Here it is. Sent back up the middle, and that is through into center field, a base hit. He's safe at the plate, and they've jumped ahead here in the 10th.
Boy, those have to feel really good, D-Row. You get late in the game, you come up with a big RBI base hit right here to give your team the lead.
Yeah, no one remembers that ground ball with eyes in the top of the second inning. You want to show up when the game is on the line. Can you quiet your emotions down, take the crowd out of it, and slow yourself down enough to come through? And that's exactly what he did.
Into the box now, Josh Naylor. Swing and a liner. And there's a base hit as that gets through into left. And they'll put the brakes on that runner at third, and that means the bases are loaded now with two away.
Boy, so frustrating as a pitcher. You make a quality pitch on the inside half of the plate right there. Try to bust him in, D-Row, and he fights it off the other way.
Yeah, you tip your hat to the pitcher right there. He executed his pitch, but nice job by the offensive player fighting. It doesn't matter what it looks like. A knock's a knock.
Archie Bradley answers the call to pitch here in a big spot. He inherits a bases loaded jam, but needs just one out to get out of it. Standing in now, Francisco Mejia. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1.
It often becomes harder to hit the zone when the pressure starts to heat up.
It's a 2-2 count to the Padres catcher. Two and two. Here it is. Bases are loaded here. Two down. Three and two. And now the carousel will be in motion here with two away.
Well, no doubt in my mind, this has been the at-bat of the night so far.
A swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Marte going back, and he makes the catch as just the one run comes across in the inning. So one run on three hits, no errors, and three left. So now we'll see if these guys can get even in the bottom of inning number 10. It's the Padres 5 and the Diamondbacks 4. Kirby Yates picks the ball, looking to make sure this game goes no further. Save situation here in inning number 10. Ready for the bottom of the 10th here. Into the box, Starling Marte. He flew out in his last at-bat.
Hey, it's never easy scoring runs against a closer, but this lineup is setting up perfectly right now as the leadoff hitter leads off this inning.
1-1, here it is.
One ball, two strikes.
And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Started to go. Did he hold up in time? Yes, says the first base umpire. It's ball three now. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away.
When your closer comes in and strikes out the first guy he faces, everyone on the team can kind of take a deep breath. Still have two more outs to get, but retiring that leadoff guy is always huge when you're trying to shut a game down.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Taken, strike two.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
The 1-2. And it's fouled away. It's two balls and two strikes now. drilled to the right side. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single. Time called here, as with the potential tying run aboard, they'll make the move to get a little more speed out there. In now, Ketel Marte. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Step on the bag for one. Back to first. It's a double play right when he needed it, and this ball game is over.
Hey, it took them an extra frame to do it, but hey, they're not going to complain as they lock up a nice road victory here in 10 innings.
This evening's game comes to an end, 5-4, the final tally.